I'm Rancorn, and welcome to Tech Time. As always, this is a show about paratechnology. Gadgets that I use on a regular basis, new stuff, stuff that I've built, stuff I incorporate. And always trying to come up with a new idea as far as something that will make your investigation, I know mine, easier. And, you know, who knows, may be able to work for you. So thank you so much for joining me tonight. Yes, this is a all-new live show, and still got my work duds on because I've been working late here lately. So I really would appreciate you hanging with me. I've got a great show tonight. Just recently, this last weekend, I met up with my good old pal Richard Rulin and his group, Hunting the Unknown Truth, and we went down to Nickajack Lake and investigated the infamous Hales Bar. At first, you would think actually it is a bar, if you would say, but it is not really a bar per se, but it's actually a electrical dam that was generating power so many years ago. And from this, of course, they made many altercations. Instead of damming it up, they tore it down and kind of left the building itself as far as a, you know, structure that has been abandoned for some time. And of course, you know, within this element of an abandoned building and something that basically was operational a long time ago, there is that distinct possibility that you have something, I guess, residing in there, or even the possibility of a long-time worker that was, you know, either possibly passed away, or during the construction some accidents happened. Who knows? There might be something clinging to it. But, you know, we'll get into the tech part, and I'm going to show you a little bit as far as what I've come across here lately that's really benefited me as far as within my investigations. Now, what I'm talking about, you know, various people have cameras and things that people actually have utilized in the future as far as harnesses or just holding or you know, things to help stabilize people's cameras and camcorders. Well, it's real difficult to get a real good true picture unless you utilize things like harnesses or holders in order for you to be able to grip them. Now, one of the things I've come across is this right here. No, it's not some medieval torture device. It's actually a shoulder strap for you to be able to stabilize some of your camera equipment. And what you actually do is, it has a back brace, and you strap it over your shoulder just like this, because of course you want your little stabilizer and connector to hold your camera right here in front of you, to where you'll be able to have your camera setting right here. And the strap actually stabilizes it to where, you know, you'll be able to keep everything stable. And I have it, you know, pretty well adjusted where it fits me. And so you're all strapped in. And so there you go. You've got a nice, stable little environment here for you to be able to strap on a camera. Now, one of the things that I've used a lot here lately, and it's given me some really good quality video, and you'll see in the coverage that I'll show you of the walkthrough with the Hunting the Inside, Hunting the Unknown Truth, is my Sony PD-170. And what I do with the Sony PD-170, it records, you know, of course, in mini DVs, but it also gives me film coverage and real clear colors and HD quality. So So within this, and many of your cameras, they'll have, you know, a little attachment here, right here in the bottom, for you to be able to screw in, you know, many different holders. And of course, with this one, you have a holder right here on the end. And so what I do is just get it in there, and as far as the holder, and just tighten it up. And once I get it all good and tightened up, you have to find the hole first. And then once you get it strapped in, well then guess what? You've got a stabilized camera holding device that looks extremely professional. And so with that, and it being extremely stable, you know, you're able to, you know, still view your device. But with this, you have all kinds of stability. Stability, which is key to get that good, crisp, clear shot, especially in any of your investigations. So, you know, this is a little nidbit that I used when I was filming here at the Hales Bar, and found it, you know, very comfortable. You know, anyone that knows, if you have pretty heavy equipment, that it can be very overbearing after, you know, hours of investigating. With a shoulder strap like this, well then basically it alleviates a lot of that stress, to where you're more focused on getting your shots, your stability, what camera angles you want, and not having to worry about your arms getting sore and going, oh my God, do I have to carry this camera one more time? You know, so this is a very nifty device, you know, as far as the camera holder itself. So I'm gonna take this and unstrap it back off, and you know, just one of those things where basically, you know, something I've come across to, you know, I was going to share with you and better help. So, that's my technology tip of the night. So, getting on to bigger and better things, as always, one of the things I like to talk about my show is actually space weather. Space weather is really key as far as any kind of correlation with many different types of events that could actually be influenced by solar rays or the geomagnetic field of the Earth. Because being a scientist, and many of the other people that are close in my field, as far as trying to get pure scientific evidence to give the paranormal field credibility, utilizes this information in order to possibly explain those paranormal events. So let's take a quick look at the space weather and see that actually right now, if we focus in on the elements right here, the sonar x-rays are active, and so we may have some correlation if you so happen in the next day or so going on paranormal investigation, or if you have in the last couple of days, you know, there might be some correlation if you are having some sort of freakish paranormal event. So within this chart, you see six different charts here, which basically explain a lot of different things as far as the solar data. From this, you get your X-ray flux right here, your satellite environment, which basically says what kind of X-rays or X-ray bombardment. And then within this element is what I keep a lot of, is actually the element of a pretty much a forecast, for instance, like the next day or so, what might actually be happening. So if you have an event or something coming up, I would look at this chart and see whether or not there's some sort of event that might be happening here in the near future. So, you know, the sonar data is very cool, it's useful, and you can use as far as any type of other correlations of events that you might be having on your investigations. Within that, I have a nice video to show you as far as this Hales Bar Investigation event. And so it's about a 41-minute take, and I would definitely like to go ahead and get that started for you.
Sure. So if we could just traverse the tunnels, even though you really don't think there's a whole lot going
on
there.
That's fine.
And then we're going to work our way in and then go upstairs to the... We'll start on a third floor, and we'll come down to the second floor overlook area, and then we'll go down to the powerhouse and end up there.
Okay.
The walkthrough, is that cool?
You just take me where you want to go.
All right. Anything outside before you go in.
I don't think we're going to run out of time if we do. That's my only concern.
Let's pack on and go where
we're running out of time. This place is gorgeous.
Yeah.
Truly is gorgeous. They cleaned us up a lot since we were here last.
Yeah.
You know it? I mean, it's just kind of different compared to how it was last time we were here. Remember they had all the boat parts and all that stuff over here?
And they've cleaned it up.
They have. They really have.
They even took out some of the broken windows, or just half windows.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and this was a mechanic shop.
Lord.
Hopefully these doors are open.
Oh.
Every time I come here, I always have to stop and look up at the third floor right-hand corner.
Well, that's because we've seen figures up there before.
We have, haven't we?
Yes, we have. The last time we were there was a figure in a third pane in the upper window right there.
Right? Whew. Is this locked up?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's how we go in now? All right.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
Can you put up a little bit?
Called the Fat Man's Door, because it was done so close together, the passage was that you couldn't be a big guy and get through.
You had to go sideways.
I had to go sideways to get through it, but, and you're going to hear a lot of echo in this hallway too, but there is a lot of asbestos when you go through that doorway, and that area up above is loaded with asbestos. So for safety reasons, the company running this establishment now has barred off that entrance, but frankly, there's been a lot of stuff that happens enough right here that we don't have to go that way. We're going to start down here at the end of the tunnels and work our way through the building, so stay with us through this. We have to make a trip to Walmart. And watch out for the divots in the floor. The best place to walk through on this is in the middle. Until you get racked in the back of the head by an arm that sticks out of the wall as well. These tunnels were built back in the day to be able to have piping work through here for the dam. And they used to actually come in here and service these pipes and stuff, and conduits used to come through here. You're almost under the ground, but not really. And this area in here has been, where did they get
one? It looks like some kind of pipe sticking out.
Nice. This area has been reputed, proven by us in several investigations, as being very active. Snapshots of apparitions have been taken in here, shadow people, a lot of disembodied voices. We've caught here before, hopefully this time around as well. And of course the acoustics, thank you. Of course the acoustics are incredible. So I'm gonna spin before I get hurt. What are we doing here? What is this?
It's just a thing that goes down, I don't know.
It never used to be like that. Okay.
I guess we have to walk around that.
Thank you.
Maybe
where it gets a little different.
Yeah, watch out for your side.
Yeah, watch your left side.
And the big...
set up for tours. They do tours in here.
There's toys set over here.
Yeah. There's toys set up over here that I think probably even had a team that runs the tours in here now. And people previously, they used to call this area Mary's Corner or Mary's portion of the tunnel because they feel that they've had some communication with children in here. Well, Mark, our medium, and everybody with us fully in agreement. You call out for children, there's going to be children here. They will do whatever they need to be able to get your attention. And they put the toys here because the theory was they would give the children something to be able to play with. And you know, so they've got that set up. Back when this was a dam, and the dam ran all the way through to the other side, the children used to have to go under the lake to be able to go to school. Because their parents worked here. So the theory about children traversing this area here, you know, they come over with people that are here to do investigations. When they can sense people that are here that they can communicate with, they're gonna come. You're probably gonna hear some of them tonight because between Mark and a few other people on the team, there's gonna be reasons for them to wanna talk. But this has always been for us a pretty active EVP area. For us before, so hopefully this time. Are you getting anything here? No, I know you said originally the tunnels really weren't.
Really, right now, the tunnel does not feel very active to me.
Okay.
Now, there will be, I feel like it's more, the meat and potatoes is more in the belly at the moment.
Okay. So, well, right, we're going to make our way there.
Yeah, right now, here. No.
As Tommy's throwing stuff at me now.
That's the fourth time, hopefully, I just dropped it. Actually, it was PK. Really?
Now there are more. There are adult energies that are around in here.
Okay.
But there are no children at the moment.
But there was claims in here, and there's been claims been made in here. I actually haven't been able to see, except for one time in a photo, but of a man that has been seen by the living in this tunnelway exiting constantly. It's almost residual based on the claims I've heard because he's going and he's coming and he's going and he's coming.
Shadow seems to take the same path.
Yeah. Now this has got this place has got some personal significance to me. My aunt by marriage actually used to play Billy Joe's aunt would actually play in these tunnels as a kid when her father worked here back when he worked for the TVA. So there is some connection here with our family. So we've always felt the job to be able to do this place correctly for the viewing public. So. But this is kind of the end of the tunnel, so again, you're saying the majority of what you're feeling is in the main building.
They really have.
And again, they're going to have a tour in here tonight, so we're going to be, next time you see us on film after this walkthrough, it's going to be at night because they have a tour coming through before we actually do our investigation. So, but now we're going to take you into the control room area, all the way up to the third floor and start our way down from there, just to be able to give you a sense of what's going in through the building during the daytime, so stay with us. Kill that if you want to, because we're going to be walking back that way. It's such an honest feel
of this place when you look down the tunnel.
I love it. It's such a wild feeling.
You ready to roll, Daddy-O?
Richard, I've always come to the conclusion that you never stop filming.
You're going to edit it out, buddy.
I'm just saying, there's no telling what you're going to catch.
Your glasses were cold when you came in here, weren't you?
Are you fogged up a little bit?
It's
fine.
It's fine
in
here.
You know what I mean, Tommy? Just as soon as you shut anything down,
I smell like crazy. All
right.
Yeah, that's me. I was like, am I in focus? Because I can't see crap.
You guys need little fans that blow on you.
Little fans, little personal fans on your camera.
Oh, yeah. Only the you.
I used to have fans, but I pissed them off.
I can't believe they did this with a pipe.
I don't remember it being like
that. No, it wasn't like that. It was over here to the left. This was shoved over here.
Maybe they did it just to turn people up.
Maybe they did it to set
a camera on it.
Wait, look at some of these old lighting. Look at some of these old lighting pictures.
Oh, wow.
Look at this.
Think about the kind of tools you'd have to have to put this up here.
Yeah.
But it would make a good place to put like a piece of plywood and put a camera on it.
It would take
really?
A spanner wrench with about an 8-inch bite on it.
Mm-hmm. Huge.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I thought you were behind us.
It's all right. We were looking at the pipe.
I'm sorry. My bad.
I said it would be a great place to put a piece of plywood in the camera.
Yeah. Really, I'm kicking myself for forgetting that brace.
Oh, it's a cool spot.
Yeah.
There's a cool spot you guys are going to be hitting.
He got it cut off. They were doing something. He lost a little appendage.
And it's in the concrete.
It's in the concrete.
Okay.
That's so sad.
I know when they built the Brooklyn Bridge that happened.
Yeah.
Now we
gotta go this way. That ends.
Watch out.
Stay alive. Watch your step. Put step in the corner.
We go this way, right?
Yeah, we're gonna go this way. All right, the area we're gonna go into now is the control room area. That's pretty infamous for activity. Oh, wait.
Right here?
Yeah, let's close it off.
Well,
this is, I think.
I thought so, but I don't know.
Are we gonna go out to get to the... This door?
How do you say?
It's been a little while.
This was never closed.
No.
Okay.
Yes.
Cool. Watch your step.
Watch your step. It's a little bit of a short step.
Watch your step. Everybody, watch your step. Little cowboy action.
No, there wasn't
a cowboy. Oh, well. They're beginning to play with you already. That's nice. My wife, leave her alone. Oh, the old musty smell. This is back when you had the resistors, everything to help generate power. Looks basically like they snapped it all off and sold the parts. Pretty nasty.
That's what I thought.
Oh, did you?
It felt just like it felt the first time I was here.
Crazy.
We were commenting last night about the fact that most people the first time we...
By the way.
Yeah, our time.
The other way.
Usually get scratched.
Yeah.
I, however, did not. I got...
Okay, guys. Okay, we're gonna go upstairs. So we're going to shoot ourselves upstairs for a moment. We're going to take it all the way to the third floor, where it kind of, the building kind of begins with the activity and kind of work our way back down again. I've got a little bit of going on right now for me, but I'm assimilating my location with myself. So every time I'm coming here and every time the team's come here, we've always had, Billy Jones is telling me, just walk through, she's like, what's that? And basically something evidently she ran through coming through the hallways a minute ago. And you're gonna hear some noises too because the windows are mostly out of this building.
So there's a lot of birds flying around.
A lot of birds. But let's go ahead and follow ourselves off to the third floor and begin our process from there. At least the steps are still stable.
Yeah, they are. Actually, more stable than you expect.
Coming.
This is where the Darby.
Oh, okay.
Right here.
I know.
And
this is where I had a guy who opened this door up.
Yeah.
I told him not to. And when he opened this door up, a dark mass came running through. He was here and got shoved off the steps, 6 feet across on his shoulders.
And there was nothing from here down.
Dirt from here up.
Now see where we have dirty stairs, dark mass.
Oh.
But I'll show you where it originates.
Okay.
Which is over in a room over.
Okay.
But then it originates over there.
Okay.
But we're not getting to it in this way. We have to go over now.
Yeah, there's another room called the... I call it a mossy room.
Yeah, now this room wasn't, this wall wasn't there at one time, and that causes the weird flow.
Awesome. This is the mossy room here, Mark.
Huh? Yeah.
It's over there. Yeah, that's a creepy room.
That's the mossy room.
This is where the dark mass that comes in, that is the dimensional veil, the membrane. And if you put a camera here, this is where you'll see the undulating dark mass of the veil, or the dimensional veil, that stretches and tears and repairs. But you may be able to get it on film at night. But this is where this originates from. Then through the walls and through the stuff, it's
right.
Where it goes through when you see Darby.
Okay.
And you can basically see why we call it the monster.
But the dark mass, what really happens is the dark mass comes through the wall.
Yeah.
It's coming, it's an elemental energy that's
This room, every time I come into it, it can happen again now. It's like I hit a wall. Does that make sense?
Well, that's because it is a wall.
I mean, I literally got here and just went, whoosh.
Yeah. Well, when you see the dark mass, that is what that is. And so it is a wall that goes through these concrete walls. But okay. It's its own moving dimensional thing. It goes over a mound this far.
Yeah.
Without the scroll leg. But it goes through, it's an elemental piece that comes through, then goes back.
Okay.
But when it's retreating, if you are behind it, you'll see phenomena, and on the other side of you, you'll see phenomena.
And what's funny is this is not even for me, what was that for?
No. But
we're coming to it now.
Yeah, in here.
In here, too, look. Well. No, it's on the other side of that wall. You come in here to the, you go to the right where Mark is?
Yeah, it's not this wall.
When you come in here and go to the left? I'll show you. This place in here, a lot of water, a lot of slippery limestone, so watch the step.
Okay.
This area, here, here is where I get most stuff we've got up here. What do you think, Mark?
I think it's when the energy is activated because it's whirlpool, that when the energy is beginning to disperse that, you feel that in your stomach.
Yeah, I'm feeling it.
It's leftover energy that ends up in the corner because it's just dying down. So, but you get the darker, crappier,
the feeling in the leftover,
and that makes you nauseous. You know when you're not so feeling nauseous? Mm-hmm. It's because of the edge of the energy that's creeping out.
Okay.
Now, the one time we've been here, I put a digital recorder on that platform, static.
Yeah.
We went downstairs and investigated the tunnels.
Yeah.
I come back 2 hours later, pick it up and play it backwards.
Yeah.
Play it back. I've got a little boy voice that walks over to him and goes, "Who's this?" And then he says, basically, if you close your eyes and you try to put it in, you remember this kid. It was sounding like he was sitting on the floor in Indian position. It was creepy.
No.
But this, like that wheel.
Yeah.
Now, as you can see, it's moving now.
It's moving now.
And it's been told. No, I've been told that if you ask it to move the other direction, as you see, it's moving now. There's absolutely no reason.
Well, it's airflow.
Well, I've been told.
Actually, that's what people would say. It was airflow that's making it move.
I've been told that if you stop it and you ask it to go the other direction, it'll go the other direction.
Well, like it's picking up speed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's not wind. I don't think that's wind. Do you think that's wind?
I don't know what that is. I don't do wheels.
That's a heavy wheel, too.
I have no idea.
Okay.
Well, it's going
to go. There it goes again. I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that it's warped.
Yeah.
And that has a lot to do with the... Because it just spins.
The only reason I said it was wind is because the outside wind picked up and then the wheel started moving faster.
Well, is it is it got to...
Well, this would be the... Deck,
yeah.
This
but
has
reached
outside.
I don't know. This whole thing, this is a belt wheel. This one's a something.
But this leads outside for the cold.
Now this starts. There it goes back to
the other. Yeah, see, I was going the other way.
Okay, maybe it's not wind.
Now we go the other way. Turn it the other way.
That's volcanic.
Let's go up.
Volcanic.
Okay.
It's a kind of fan that's got fins all the way around.
No.
I'd rather be sure.
When in doubt, debunk it out.
Right. Rather be sure.
Now, this next section. This
where
next
is that room? That one room that I always go in, and it always seems to calm me. And I get to that room, it's really small, and it, you kind of go weave through in this little section in the room.
Trying to think.
And when you're in there, the EVP action in there is crazy, but I just don't really remember.
Do you remember four times? Now, this floor, no. On this floor, though, there have been apparitions seen. Supposedly, I haven't had it happen to me, and we'll see. Supposedly, an apparition comes out of here and actually will physically chase you out of this room if you're by yourself.
A previous member of our team said it happened.
Huh?
One of the members that used to be a part of our team said it happened to him.
Yeah.
It chased
him. And this also happened. This is where Mark, another guy, was going to chase.
I
actually had to pull him out of the building because he was getting choked out.
This one.
He felt his hands around his throat and he was getting choked out and he couldn't really catch his breath. And I'm actually having to track him.
I'm talking about the same. And another time he had to run out of here.
Yeah, but you see an easy
victim. Well, you get a lot of derelict energy up here because it just gets flung out of the. The vortex kind of energy that's going around like this.
Is that the whirlpool? Is the whirlpool a portal?
Well, it's that, yeah. Sort of.
Okay.
Well, yeah.
Is it a timely thing? Is it an issue where the vortex time, certain times in the set vortex?
I think in different seasons, it's different. It responds.
And when the water changes?
When the water changes, when the
stomach and I are not our best friends. Not my best friend. Watch one, so I'm real slippery. This next section.
And he keeps people out because, you know, keep them from getting hurt.
Okay. So he's going to do it for their own good.
Yeah.
He's going to get people out of here for their own good.
But when that energy comes through here, it also goes into that room. And that's where you get your black undulating mass. But what you're doing is you're seeing it from the other hand, other side of it.
Before it's scaring you instead of what it's meant to do, which was to keep
it's
you.
It's your intensity.
What's funny about that is, the first time I was here, the kid, Justin, he was going up those stairs, I had my back turned to him,
yeah.
And as he's going up the stairs, I couldn't see him, but I could hear him. I'm like, don't go up there, it's not safe. Don't go, and he's pushing the door open when the entity came out him and basically threw him across the floor.
Well, he's not supposed to be up there. Because if you look at the way that room is looked,
he would have fell through the... If he had stepped, he would have fell through the floor.
So, yeah. He's kind of...
Well, I mean, this kind of bodes to... It kind of makes sense to what you're saying about it being a protective...
It's not really as much a...
The next floor.
Ready
for it. I love the next floor, sorry. This is one of my favorite parts of this entire building.
Well, Derbig is not... He's intense, but he really is meaning to try to keep people from getting hurt.
Okay.
Because this wasn't meant to be taken tourists through. It was meant to be a functioning powerhouse. So it's not meant for play,
But this whole next floor.
Yeah.
As you're clapping, it's like
that next floor.
Yeah.
There isn't a place in there that I've ever felt wasn't active.
Sure.
And the player down there, I get the feeling, tell me if I'm wrong, because you would know. It seems like, we'll see. It almost seems like from the overlook area that we're going to go to.
Yeah.
Like he bounces between there and the other side of the other.
Oh, that's what I believe too.
Well, when I
we all believe that from the last time we were here.
Although, I don't know, because the first time I was here, I got that light rub on my arm.
That was downstairs on the second
floor. That was where you're talking about, that one overlook section.
Yeah.
Where everything I've ever felt on the other side is not that way. It's dark. It's not the same thing.
Okay. But this floor down here, we've left buckets on the ground with a static recorder. That's the first time we were here. 23 EVPs, and nobody was even asking a question. We had stuff walking up to the recorder saying, now what?
Yeah.
We had stuff walking up to the recorder begging for help.
Where was it in here where we got the no power?
That's my little area. All
right, well, let's check.
All right, watch y'all step.
Let's go over to this
little dicey on these steps. A lot dicey on these steps.
Especially that step, it's narrow.
Yeah.
Can we go this way?
Sure. Do you think this is the little room you're talking about?
No, it's
not
top.
Yeah. See, I don't know.
For a
It catches the end of the dead flow.
Okay. Nice. Whoever it was wanted to talk.
Yeah.
Now, the problem I'm going to run into, does that mean we don't have access?
Well, we'll have to go downstairs.
Downstairs?
Yeah, or down to where the whirlpool is.
Well, no, the area I'm talking about.
I know, but they're not
going to lock it all up.
What time is it?
Yeah,
okay,
because
we only
have to.
Hey, Rich.
Yes.
We only have
another 10 minutes.
Okay.
There is a man who guards that door down that way.
Why does he say
Archie?
Is that where you said that we couldn't get to because of the passage?
Well, you can't. No. This leads to the back room here. This is the area where.
Is that on the side?
No. This is an area where there's you've got a ton of EVPs back here. The area that you had your issues in is around here. And,
we need to get to the people before we have to
just walk. Yes, I understand. Mm-hmm.
Well, see, down here, you've got. See where the birds are? There's a guy named Archie down there. But. I don't feel anything too. Too bad. Too bad. It's not too bad. So, right here is just dirty.
It's a dirty like.
It's like dirty.
Dirty. Hmm? This dirty or dirty like energy?
Dirty, filthy energy. Leftover.
Can't get to it. Okay. The area that the overlook? Can't get to it.
Well, we'll have to go downstairs.
No, I'm talking about the overlook over the.
Yeah.
It's over
We've
the.
We've got a top whirlpool.
It's not the whirlpool area, it's above the whirlpool area.
On this side. It should be right here on this side.
You got. Yeah. I definitely marked that.
Right there.
Yeah, you heard it too?
That's it.
Oh, this is it.
This is it. This is what. Oops, sorry. I'm sorry.
This is the area.
This
here.
Is where we were trying to get to.
Yeah. Hello?
Oh.
This is the area
well,
here
that's
for us.
Well, it just got interesting for a minute.
This is the area here for us that has been very interesting.
It tries to slide closed. Yeah.
Now this is one of the
practices.
100 step, which is that one.
Over there.
And 7 foot. It's tied when she calls it the crow's nest.
Yeah.
That's the crow's nest. And her husband Thomas is speaking in the I think he's talking about the water.
Okay.
That's Sarah Foster. But this is what they call the crow's nest.
This area. Here is where I've had the entity twice, two different occasions, roll up to my microphone when I said in the power of Christ, I command you to leave now. Roll up to my microphone and went, oh, pow. And then he just backs off. And he's done that twice in two separate occasions.
Well, because it doesn't have the same belief system.
Oh, I understand that. But it's a little disconcerting nonetheless.
Yeah, he just doesn't believe what you believe.
That's okay. What I believe in is going to protect me, so I'm not that worried about it.
It'll protect you, but it doesn't, but
has
it
nothing
doesn't
to
affect
him.
Him because it's not.
He just likes to say it just to kind of say it's
to freak you out.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Well, good
Which
job.
Works.
He's done.
It works. And now that's why they do it.
So,
now, Rich was asking earlier, is the same entity that's over here over there?
Yeah.
I have to wait until I get over there to be able to see. Now, Sarah talks about her husband Thomas up here. So.
Okay.
And I don't know if Foster is the married name, but if it is, then it would be Thomas Foster or Thomas might be the last name.
No.
But he's pretty much in the crow's nest. This is where they could look out and watch everything. So the supervisors.
Okay.
So
kind of the big ones. Too.
The bigger people more in charge who are watching everything. Down there working bees.
Your wall?
Hmm? Working bees.
Oh, that's not my wall. I know exactly where my wall is.
Now this area. Right here.
My wall is right here.
We lovingly call this Billy Joe's wall because when she was filming our show once.
I had a camera in my hands.
About the same amount of distance
exactly.
She was at before, and literally felt this and was called the damn bitch.
My feet never
so,
moved.
So, never moved. I saw her go backward, so it wasn't as if she was swaying or anything. Literally just, you said it felt like somebody just shoved
you
up against the wall.
It felt it. Like something pushed me.
And then I got called the damn bitch.
Which I didn't hear with my ears.
No, we played back DVPs and saw it. Actually, it's on our website.
First time
so,
for everything.
That's on our website. But this whole area up here, for some reason, has always been an active little spot, so.
And the funny thing is I said, well, maybe we should move. Just before that, I said, maybe we should move because nothing here wants to talk to us anyway.
Yeah.
So it's being a little bit of a smart butt. And
yeah.
Then well, I gave you
your
information.
Yeah.
But yeah, you'll get called things like that sometimes in investigations because spirits are people. And like you can have people who are just jerks. You know,
and
they're dead, but they're still jerks.
I've had the belief that whatever you are in life, you're personified in death.
Yeah, and it's a little bit more intense than if they were dark.
Well, that, I think this place in particular, the different people that come in here always have different things happen to them.
Yeah.
Depending on even your mood when you come in.
Yeah, when you come in. And, but, you know, I mean, there's the flow here used to go all the way up there and da 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 da. But this is, you know, for people in charge, you're not supposed to be here if you're not in charge.
Well, if there's any place in this entire building, it has ever given me the creep factor. It's this area here.
Okay.
See, mine is
I don't know why, but.
But it's because
really.
You're not supposed to be up here.
Well, even after being shoved against the wall here, this is not the spot that bothers me.
It's
over there.
Well, let's go to it. Let's just do that. That was our intention anyway before the daylight runs out. Let's go take a look at it.
Let's go look.
Who is?
Oh, track lights.
This was the control panel.
Yeah.
Crazy.
If this was not
May.
Your place to be, you weren't supposed
yeah.
to be here.
This is where you could get in and really screw stuff up.
Yeah, well, that makes sense.
By hitting the wrong switch or cutting the wrong
dial.
Is
that where fuses were?
Where? Probably. Where?
All kinds of stuff.
Yeah, but you're not,
well,
yeah. So the energies that are here, they're actually, you know, you're just not supposed to be here.
Well, be careful when you walk through, please.
Yeah, don't
be careful
yeah.
when you walk
Except
through.
If you step in the wrong spot here, you're going to hurt yourself.
Yeah, you'll hurt.
Like there's nothing there at all.
If you were doing an investigation and you put something over here.
Yeah.
And over here. I mean, everything in the whole building came right over here.
Well, it makes sense.
How many people worked, you know what I mean? I mean, putting their blood, sweat, and tears right here.
My wife's grandfather worked here.
Wow.
He worked here and was TVA run. My aunt, like I said, she used to play in the tunnels waiting on him to get off work.
Wow.
She played in the tunnels. And when this place was investigated,
without saying too many names. When this place was investigated, it was booked in January and aired in booked in November, taped in November, ran in January, and they're from the Northeast. When they were here, they said two very vitally important things that really ticked off a lot of Tennesseans. Number one, they said everything in here is residual.
Yeah.
Oh, what? And then he said, nothing in here is going to hurt you. Now, this aired after my young guy got shoved across the floor on his shoulders. After he got scratched, I got scratched, and he was made so nauseous he puked right over there. But nothing here going to hurt you.
I'll be moving now.
Yeah. So
there is a nauseous feeling.
There is. It hits me right in the gut.
Because I just started sweating profusely.
Yeah. And your heart races.
Yeah.
And then your gut, because they love entering the body from the solar plexus. That's what Mark will tell you. I always wondered why that happened when I went into investigations. And he's like, that's why. That's your energy source. So they hit you right there, and they pull from there. Are you guys all right?
Yeah, we're fine.
Okay, let's roll. Hold the light.